and that's a chronic illness and travel. We are on our way back from a trip to Carolinas for a family reunion. We had an awesome time with some great cousins and uncles. My brother and his family, it was amazing. But just wanted to do a general topic video on chronic illness and travel, specifically MS this time. You can do it even if you are in a wheelchair, need a lot of assistive devices, are extremely heat and cold intolerant. It just takes more planning. It takes giving yourself more breaks and having a little more assistance sometimes, but it can be done. The key is pre-planning. Make sure that you give yourself lots of extra time to get ready for the trip, extra rest. Make sure you have all of your medications refilled ahead of time to take with you. Extras if needed in case of emergency and your return trip is delayed. Equipment, make sure you have a plan in place in case you have any kind of equipment failure. You have support systems and aren't caught alone without assistance if possible. It is quite a chore packing up for a road trip specifically with MS. Lots of extra things to pack. Wheelchairs, canes, walkers, whatever you need to use. Cooling devices, coolers, nebulizers, machines. There's lots of extra things to pack. But it can be done. So get out there, enjoy your family. Once you arrive, remember you will need extra rest time before you engage in an activity. But you can do this. Once you're in an event, be mindful of temperature changes, voice fatigue levels. You may even have to excuse yourself for a moment from the event and then return. Friends and family will understand, so just give yourself a break and take the time you need to get back in the action and join in the fun. But just wanted to give that little encouraging note to everyone to get out there at any stage of progression and enjoy. Just make sure it's well planned and that you give yourself plenty of rest and, if possible, and try to plan for downtime once you get home. I love you guys and hope you had a wonderful